course, the NACFIL. Third would be the reconceptualization of the Catechism for Filipino Catholics. I'm directly in charge of that. We are now revising the CFC. The CFC, so kindly inform our people. But we still need to look into the framework of revision. And that will be presented in the AMCM. In the AMCM, Sister Mother Jess will say a few words regarding the venue as well as the costing, as well as Monsignor Tony from the Archdiocese of Cebu. And we have gotten a venue for that. And what we need would be solicit from you also suggestions on possible movements of in Cebu conferences as well as input. I suggest that instead of getting speakers from Manila, might as well get speakers from Cebu. The reason is because the church in Cebu is very rich in terms of history as well as theology. They have San Carlos Major Seminary there. And of course, even the Archbishop of Cebu is a theologian himself. So for us to minimize movements, might as well get our speakers. And it's Monsignor who would help us identify possible input. Might as well enrich each other with the local church or the particular church instead of always getting from Imperialist Manila. So, suggestion ko lang yun, lagi na lang Manila. So, pag nasa Manila, di sa Manila, pero kung nasa Cebu, Cebu, pag Davao, get the people in Davao, right? So, because they're also doing their own share in terms of theological reflection and pastoral expertise and experience. There are other agenda items, so if you have some suggestions. So, what we're doing now is direction setting that would we would bring in our meeting of the technical working group. The technical working group is assisting the bishops, ECCE, or Episcopal Commission of Catechesis and Catholic Education, covers two major groups. What are they? CEAP, as the organization of Catholic schools, colleges, and universities, as well as the Association of Catholic Universities, or ACU. Bishop Bobet is ex officio member of the boards of these two groups. So in terms of Catholic education, they're highly organized. The second group is our group, namely the Catechetical Directors and Coordinators of dioceses of particular churches, as well as priests who are assigned by their bishop also in the catechetical ministry. So it's not only simply catechetical directors, but priests who have been engaged and involved in the catechetical work of the particular church. And that is supposed to be one of the things that we're doing. And one of the programs that we would want to bring into, and we will request Dr. Lisander of De La Salle University to say a few words about the program that will begin next week, which is the Certification of Catechetical Leadership and Supervision, which is now under the auspices of the Christian Brothers. Actually, that's under BAMCREF. BAMCREF is the Brother Adelino Manuel Catechetical Religious Foundation, which is the foundation in charge of that. The Christian Brothers have been into this and have supported the program of ECCE. That will begin next week. We would want to hear from Dr. Lisander regarding updates, because there are a good there are a number of directors who have expressed their willingness. And yun ang first objective eh, mga catechetical directors, because walang competencies eh. You need competencies to manage a catechetical program. And hopefully, this is at least an eye-opener, skills improvement, and competency building. Because we would want to hear from Dr. Lysander kung ano yung programa. 10 days, no? 12 days. 12 days with one immersion in the parish of Father Dengs, which is the rich parish of Makati. And Father Dengs will take care of the food as well as the giveaways and handouts. St. John Bosco Parish, the rich Salesians. So, but may immersion doon isang Sunday, no? So, Dr. Lysander will say a few words. Right? So, okay na ba yun, agenda? Yeah. Any addition to the agenda for our business meeting? Mother Jess? Ah, Bishop, sorry po.
Ano lang, before we go to the agenda. Just before we go to the agenda, I was told by Father Carlo that Bahay Pare Cooperative is open for proposals coming from the directors, catechetical directors. They are willing to support projects and especially training programs for catechists. Retreats of catechists, they are willing to support up to 100,000 daw. So, kaya lang, siguro, they will screen pa yung mga projects na propose natin. Sabi, they usually do not support yung mga gadgets o mga computers, ayan, yung mas binibigyan nila ng importance yung mga training programs. So, kung pwede, you can send your proposals and sa sino ba yung ano, Senior Jerry, yung head ng
Anton Pascual.
Father Anton Pascual.
Tapos so, loan or grant?
Hindi, it's a grant. Ito ba natin ito? Yun lang pa, kasi baka makalimutan ko before we go to the agenda. So we now proceed to the agenda.
Okay. Thank you. Mother Jess has another agenda. So let us begin. The Summer Catechetical Institute for Priests is in Korea. Proposal is dates April 9 to 12 of 2018. April 9 is a week after Easter week, which is after the second Sunday of Easter, after Divine Mercy Sunday. So Divine Mercy is April 8. Easter Sunday is April 1. So April 9 to 12. So I suggest that we fly to South Korea in the morning of the 9th. And then we get back after lunch of April 12. Is that okay? Okay na ba yung mga araw na yon na okay ba 3 days? Father Dex?
If we are there for catechetical exposure, we need to stay in Korea on a Sunday because catechesis in Korea for children and young people is done on Sundays. And Sundays are not catechesis. So which is quite structured like catechesis in school. Because in Korea, catechesis in schools do not mean help unless it's a Catholic school. So the majority of Catholic schools do not have catechesis. So what you technical program in our first communion, confirmation, and then ongoing catechesis is done on every Sunday in each parish.
So Sunday, dapat ang tatamaan ngayon, Fathers, would be Divine Mercy Sunday. May mga devotions kasi sa parokya, no? Gusto niyo the week after?
Third Sunday
is April 16, is the third Sunday. So, which means that we can fly there April 14, Saturday. Okay ba yun? Okay. April 14 to 17. Pwede ba yun?
Basta may Sunday.
So, April... Fathers, okay na ba yun?
Yes, Lord. 14 to... 13 to...
18. Saturday yun, Saturday.
13 to
14. Tanong ko sa akin, Director. Wala na po. Nag...
14, 15, 16, hanggang 17. Okay ba yan? 17?
19.
Ano ba lang siya? Sabi niya, hindi niya magagabayan. So...
Hanggang 19, gusto niya?
Padre Saldo na po ngayon. Yes. Hindi rin siya makarating ngayon. Coordination kami kahapon.
North Korea.
Yun na kayo makakalabas po.
Yun yan.
So, okay. So... Okay na ba sa inyo? Once again? Skip is April 14 to 19. We fly 14 in the afternoon and we get back 19 in the morning. I preferably siguro we can stay in a pastoral center, a bishop's house or a retreat house. We'll just look. I'm not comfortable naman staying in a hotel. Stay with assistance. Okay. No. Mother will look for a place in South Korea. Any suggestions? Agenda? Interfaith dialogue? Is that okay with you?
I think I know, because it is the year of the priest and next year is the year of the priest. Pending the priest as a man of dialogue. Pending.
That's the mode of church. Yes, thank you, Bishop. Maybe we can focus on that because the mode of church in Asia is dialogue. Father Dex?
Kailan the topic of dialogue in the Church of Korea might not be very actual kasi the Korean culture is very hierarchical.
Maybe in Korea, what we can do is discuss how the Korean church engages in catechesis on a Sunday.
That's one. But the Korean church is quite peculiar in the sense that it was established by the
people. Sila St. Andrew.
Maganda sila pag-aralan yung
Kim Tae-jong.
Korean church.
Maybe before we leave, have a meeting during at least background of the church in Korea, or at least we are aware. We're not going there at tabula rasa.
I will have a friend from Korea, in charge of the ministry, especially in this coming next month.
Ano yan doon, Boss Bob?
He's been here in the Philippines also. He knows the our church, our situation, especially the EC. One thing that we can learn from them, depending on how they interpret the EC, is a church of Korea.
Okay.
I can schedule a meeting with them for him to suggest to us what we can learn.
Possible topics. Pero mas maganda kasi we have topics siguro for one or two days. The rest of the time, we go around. Like when we did, when we visited Vietnam, we went around. We went around shopping. Say immersion. Mag-immersion lang para we know what to look for. So an input siguro. Maybe on the first day as we welcome, present to us the church in Korea. Right? The history, the culture, and the church. A bird's eye view. Tama? Okay. Pero I know that Korea, Japan, these countries are strongly conservative, strongly hierarchical, as compared to the church in the Philippines that has shifted to a more participatory mode of church life. But anyway, sige, we'll work on that. Any other suggestion? But we have already finalized. We'll request Manang Bishop Obed to contact the Korean Bishop. Please see to it, fathers. First request, see to it that you have updated passports. Not at the last minute. Kapagdating doon, ipasun ng passport ninyo. We will have to get visa. So I suggest, siguro sa visa application, ipadaan na lang. Tayo magpo-proseso. Si Mother Jess, ang ating travel agency. Our representative is Annalie. With in case we are put on hold, you will leave Annalie there as hostage. Any other suggestion? So okay na ba yun for Korea? So medyo matagal tayo doon, ha? Dating tayo 14 ng gabi or hapon, and then Sunday we go around, and then we have input on 16 and 17, and then we go around again. Either 17 ng hapon and 18 the whole day. Is that okay? Okay, thank you. Any other thing as we move? We move that is skip of 2018. Next program is the just an overview of the program of De La Salle, which is the certificate in catechetical leadership and supervision. Dr. Lisander, please, just a brief overview, updates on participants. This will be on May 2nd in the evening. Bishop Obed will celebrate the opening mass at 5 o'clock in De La Salle. And then the first day will be, first full day is on the 3rd of May. Up to?
May 13th.
May 13th.
So, I think some of the priests here will also attend the sessions next week until May 13. And basically, I just texted the staff and sabi niya, there are, as of today, 42 participants. We are only expecting 40, but sabi kanina, 42 siguro. Yeah. And don't worry, because if we could not make it this year, we will be offering this. If this will become successful, we will be offering this every year. But take note that this is a two-year course, two-summer program. In other words, if you participate now, actually, yung mga nakapag-register na, we gave you is some sort of a covenant or contract na signed by you, na nakalagay doon. If you will not appear next year, you have to give us at least yung something just to, siguro parang panahot lang yun or kung dapat bumalik kayo next year, because this is a two-year program. So this is not just a one-summer program. This is a two-year program. Pinadala na namin yun 2 weeks ago or 3 weeks ago, before Holy Week. and attested by the bishop. Because the understanding is, you were sent by your bishops, so dapat attested by the bishop yung so yun. And so if you could not make it this year, next year, tingnan natin, baka naman maka-attend natin. We're actually thinking baka Monsi yung yung skip next year, baka we could credit mga one or two sessions as part of the of the CCLS. If the topics naman are in line with the objectives of this program, we might as well consider crediting yung at least one or two subjects so that yun nga lang kasi may mga lay participants, lay and religious women, hindi naman sila kasama sa skip, so yun lang, that's siguro there will be another session exclusively for the non-clergy participants. So yun po.
Puro pari ito. How many have registered?
42 monks. 16 are priests, sabi lang kanina. 16 are priests and the rest are religious women. And there are a very few lay coordinators.
Questions?
We have questions. Father Dimes.
So the classes will start.
Class each day will begin with morning prayer and mass at 8 o'clock. And then yung formal class will start at 9. So 9 to 12, 3 hours in the morning, then 1:30 to 4:30, another 3 hours in the afternoon. Don't worry, Father, may break naman po yung 3 hours. Depending na yun sa lecturer kung kailan siya magbe-break.
On 8 to, we'll start at 5.
No, on May 2, we will begin at, registration begins at 7:30. Tapos, the orientation will start at 9. And then, tuloy-tuloy na po yun. The opening mass will be at 5 in the afternoon.
So, we will be there at 1 in the evening, so we'll stay there.
Yes, Father. For those who avail dun sa facilities, you can start moving in sa May 1 in the afternoon.
And we will go home on...
You will go home on May 13 in the evening. Or May 14. Kasi pwede pa rin kayo mag-stay na May 13 evening. So you can leave May 14 in the morning. Sunday morning.
How about the religion at the 3,500
yung... Yeah, 3,500 for the food for 2 weeks. And 1,500 kung nag-avail po kayo doon sa La Salle and Center yung accommodation. And then kung condo, kasi we have condo units there. I am not sure about the price.
Pag-avail ko yung
1,500. Basta na-contact nyo na po yung staff kasi parang limited lang din po.
kung hindi po,
kasi may mga pare daw na mag-uwian, like si Father Jesse is a parish priest and he is alone in the parish, he's the only priest in the parish, so uuwi siya sa hapon, sa San Pablo sa hapon. Pero Father, attendance will be checked. So Saturday meron pa pong class. Whole day pa rin po. Si Father Dex po ang May 6, Saturday. Opo, Saturday. May 7, we have exposure trips to the richest parish in Makati. And the second richest parish in Makati in the afternoon from 3 o'clock onwards. And I heard from Monsignor Jerry that he will be treating us Rockwell. So, courtesy of... courtesy of the Rockwell people, community. So si Bishop daw is invited and the rest of the gang.
Si Abel, di 1,500 ito, wala akong pupuntahan doon sa...
Sige po. Wala na po mapuntahan. Sige po.
Sa City President's
Bed. Father, meron pong ibang participants. They do not want to stay in the Los Alian Center kasi may ka-share na room. Sa Pius the 12th Catholic Center po sila. But, you know, that is quite far. And there is no direct... Sabi. Titingnan po.
Hindi yung naliguro at nag-imo.
Father...
Uuwi ng fight.
Wala nang siya talaga.
Pabalik na lang. Father, may class po kasi yung May 6. And I think the topic is very important. The spirituality of a Catholic ethical leader in the new evangelization. May 6. And... kasi you will be missing 6 hours of lecture if you don't attend one of the
Sunday
po yung exposure po. Kung talagang hindi po pwede, kung parish priest naman, okay lang naman. Hanggang 13 lang po, Father. Ang May 13 is also important because that's the last part eh. That's the last part of the program. And we will be giving you some tasks to do during the year. Ibibigay sana yun on the last day. In the last session. Afternoon session.
Sunday po yun?
On Saturday po.
Saturday.
Yes, that's Father.
Maybe it would be good for also for those who will not well be able to attend this first CCLS program, just to get an overview of the program. But nakita niyo why tuloy-tuloy at saka even weekends are important. First of all, the framework of the whole program starts with the appreciative inquiry process. And that will be given on the very first day. And then, appreciative inquiry has 4 phases. That is the discovery, dream, and then the design. The design will consist of the different modules every day. And the very last stage of appreciative inquiry is destiny, and that is for strategic planning for the participants, because the aim is to give competencies and skills to the participants to become catechetical directors or leaders eventually, or if you are already a catechetical director, to have an added what you call skills and competencies. So at the end of the program, we go to the destiny part where you are invited to do some kind of strategic planning for the year until the next summer's program. Tuloy-tuloy siya. The pastoral exposure is now for this year is on parishes for children's ministry and the ministry, and for the mother parish of the parishes of Makati, and therefore the richer than the richest, no? The parish kay Monsignor Jerry, ang exposure doon is the apostolate that Monsignor Jerry started in his parish, apostolate to the women working in the bars, in the nightclubs. Kasi wow. Yun ang niya. Siya yung kagito, patron saint ng mga ano.
So, kaya pala si Felix Brown.
Awa ka kayo kung senior kaya.
Felix Brown.
So yun po yun. In fact, what Senior was saying about next year, siguro sa yung sa skip, the pastoral exposure for this skip would be Korea. Those who will be attending the program, tapos skip takers din kayo, yung pastoral exposure no, would be the one of Korea, the Korean experience. So yun ang aim ng ano yun, ng pastoral exposure. For a catechetical leader to be, to have knowledge of the different types of apostolates that could cover eventually your catechetical ministry. Okay. So, yun po yung dahilan, kaya taatag ito, every day may bagong module, every day may bagong topic siya. So, but I think, yun lang biblical catechesis ng 2 days. Pero every day, may iba-ibang topic siya. Kaya pag na-miss yung isa, maparang bungit yung magiging information. And then, ang vision dito is the 2 summers could be equivalent eventually to 2 subjects in an MA program. Kasi eventually, pagkatapos itong first set ng summers and yung certificate, those who would like to continue, LaSalle is open to develop this certificate program to a master level, master in catechetical leadership. Kaya, so meron parang ladderized siya. Importante sa level na once you enroll here, you really take all that. Para at the end, if you want to go for a master of level, hindi kayo mahirap.
So 1 summer is actually equivalent to 6 units, which is 2 subjects already. And then if you attend the following summer, and you should attend the